furries, and welcome back to my new working time. Yeah. So I've been recently starting working on Daniel's, so basically my friend Husky Seed, yeah. And here is basically what I was able to do. Yeah, pretty much. But now I had to basically still clean out the linings, so basically make lines much better, and just a little bit to fix around this point, basically. And by the way, I have wrong pencil brush, yeah. So I need to basically just a little bit of work on these bobs, and there won't be any arm coming. Yeah. So, yeah. And I had to say that this is very rare when I'm basically working as author's references it. So, yeah. And please be safe. I always will. Yeah. So, as you can see, I asked which colors you like to have on the ref sheet, by the way. Same colors as this one. Yeah. So, yeah. I basically bet this coloring is made by using gradient. Yeah. Oh. Seems like... Yeah. Well, anyways, he can probably, or somebody can make that costume around here. So, yeah. But it's still quite cool, basically. Daniel Parker. Yeah. A beautiful husky. Basically, yeah. It's very beautiful. But yeah, so this is basically very rare when I'm basically working reference sheets for other furries and for other users who wants to get basically an reference sheets basically. Yeah. So keep that in mind, it's very rare and I'm not usually going to do reference sheets for anyone, but I made it this time. Basically, I mean, I decided actually start working reference sheets for my friends because they actually helped me, so I decided to give something in return, and I was thinking about what I can possibly to give in return. Maybe I can actually make reference sheets for them. Yeah. And this is this is still basically too big, this brush size. Maybe 8. Still too big? 5? Yeah, that's much better. Yeah. So I recently also made a live stream about drawing this entire furry seat, basically. So, yeah. And I usually don't like to basically make real-time drawings because I know that sometimes they might take like 1 hour or maybe 4 hours. So, yeah. But, yeah. And also that is basically rare when I'm actually streaming on full drawings. It's very rare. I usually prefer to just basically do paintings instead. So basically speed paintings or real-time paintings. So yeah. But why you don't do drawing videos or drawing streams often? Well, because I like to make sure that the sketchings and the sketch will be clean, beautiful and best what I can do. And I basically think that it's much better to give it a lot of time, basically. So yeah, but I decided this time actually make on one stream so they actually can see that how I do my furries indeed. So yeah. And keep in mind that I've been drawing in this way a lot, basically. Just making vectors, then sketching out the basic shapes like ears, nose, eyes, mouth, full furry, yeah. So, yeah. And I really like actually working on furry arts and furry characters, basically. But I would like to basically also learn sculpting and modeling, so I could basically do 3D arts about furries. Yay, that would be pretty awesome to do someday. Yeah. So I'm going to basically do this time 3 different layers. So basically one layer is for this front view, this second layer will be side view, and the third one will be the back view, basically. Yeah. So how are you gonna do fix those paths in the back view? Well, since I have that rogue sketching basically made like this way, I can actually see and understand that is Bob, and I can just try to figure out the beans. Like this way. Yeah. These are the beautiful beans of the Bob. Yeah. And this is basically how I can easily to fix that Bob and the beans around here, basically. Yeah. And the if I need to basically do this same shape for this next Bob, I just can basically copy this. And yeah. I can basically copy and paste that. Then I can actually flip that and just reposition it like this way, basically. Yeah. But I had to basically make sure that the lining is basically just in the way how I want them to be. Yeah. So let's say that I spent 1 hour by doing this. And probably maybe 1 or 2 hours for cleaning out the linings, making sure that every single details what I been sketching is correctly done and looks nice. That will probably take another 1 hour or maybe 2 hours. And then painting will probably take like less than 1 hour. And shading probably like a little bit, yeah. So I just wanted to say that vectoring and sketching takes all time, but then if I had to basically do cleanups, fixing lines, that also takes a little bit time. So yeah. But probably after I get this done, I'm gonna basically maybe hit on the VR chat when my friends comes back online, because they went sleeping for a while. So yeah. So meanwhile I'm basically just trying to work on this Daniel's husky seed, basically. Yeah. And basically since he gave me this image, I can actually pretty much take that image over here and just pick those colors and paint that this has it as over here, basically, yeah. But anyways, I'm gonna basically do a lot of working on here, so serious working, so yeah. See you, furballs and furries, in next time. Have a awesome day. See ya.